In our last class, we have completed the discussion on periodic properties, and today I am going to start the another important topic, that is chemical bonding. Before coming to the direct discussion on theoretical aspects of chemical bonding, let us see some of the pre-history of the chemical bonding. In nature, whatever the substances occurs, either in the form of a solid state or liquid state or in the form of a gaseous state, or in a stable condition. While water is available in the liquid state in normal conditions, while metals are always available in the form of a metallic state, gaseous are in the form of a gaseous state, and many of the solid substances which are occurs in nature or in the form of a solid state. This is all due to the nature of chemical bonding. And the theory of chemical bonding, which is also called as electronic theory of valency, given by many of the scientists like Sedgwick, Cosell, Langmuir, and etc., is based on the concept of atoms and their electronic arrangement, hence named as electronic theory of valency, and is based on the following. So, coming to the chemical bonding. The electronic theory of valency, given by Cosell, Langmuir, Lewis, Sedgwick, and others, was based on the electronic concept of atoms, hence named as electronic theory of valency. And this electronic theory of valency is based on the following facts. Valency of an element depends upon the number of electrons present in the outermost shell of an atom. The valency of an element depends upon the number of electrons present in the valence shell of an atom. For example, when we come with the alkali metals, these are having only one electron in the valence shell. Hence, the valency of alkali metal is 1. So, whatever the number of electrons present in the outermost shell of an atom, that indicates the valency of an atom. For example, alkaline earth metals having 2 electrons in the valence shell, they exhibit a valency of 2. Likewise, third A group elements, that is boron family, shows a plus 3 valency, as these elements are having 3 electrons in their valence shell. Likewise, the halogens of the 7th A group having 7 electrons in their valence shell, they exhibit a valency of minus 1, because by taking an electron from the another atom, the halogens gets satisfies their octet. Hence, the valency of halogen under the normal condition is regarded as minus 1. Coming to the second important aspect of chemical bonding, the inert gases having completely filled cell with 8 electrons, the inert gases having completely filled cell, that is a valence cell, with 8 electrons except helium, these gases are therefore chemically inert and they do not form any compound. It means in noble gases, as the outermost cell, that is valency orbit, is completed with 8 electrons having an octet, except helium which is having only 2 electrons, these atoms are completely stable due to the octet. They do not give an electron or they do not take an electron from the another atoms. Hence, the inert gases having a stable electronic configuration in the valence cell, they do not form any compound. Coming to the third important point, atoms having less than 8 electrons in the valence cell are chemically reactive and combines with other atoms. So, to have a stable electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas, atoms having less than 8 electrons in their valence cell are chemically reactive and combines with other atom so as to have a stable electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas. The combination of atoms may take place by any of the following three ways. First one is by the complete transformation of one or more electron from one atom to the another atom. By the complete transformation of one or more electron from the one atom to the another atom, this results in the formation of a electrovalent bonding or ionic bonding or a polar combination. Coming to the second point, by sharing up of an electrons between two combining atoms such that both atoms contributes equal number of electrons. By sharing up of an electron pair between two combining atoms such that both the atoms contribute equal number of electron to the electron pair, this results in the formation of a non-polar combination or covalency or a covalent combination. Coming to the third aspect, by sharing up of an electron between two combining atoms such that the shared electron pair is contributed by only one of the two combining atoms. That is, if an electron pair which combines between two atoms is belonging to any one of the two combining atoms, This results in the formation of a coordinate bond or simply a semipolar bond. So, coming to a definition of chemical bonding. What is chemical bond? Means chemical bond or chemical bonding may be defined as the combination of two or more atoms through rearrangement of electrons in their valence shell, either by sharing of electrons among themselves or by the transformation of an electron from one atom to the another atom, so that all the atoms attain the stable configuration of nearest noble gas. Chemical bonding may be defined as a combination of two or more atoms through rearrangement of electrons in their valence shell, either by sharing up of an electrons among themselves or by the transformation of an electron from one atom to the another atom, so that all the atoms attain the nearest noble gas configuration. Coming to the types of chemical bonding, the following are the important types of chemical bonding. The first one is a ionic bond or a polar or a electrovalent bond. Second one is a covalent bond or a non-polar bond or a covalent bond. Third one, coordinate bond or a semipolar bonding. Along with these three important types of bonding, that is ionic bond or a ionic bonding, covalent bond or a covalent bonding, coordinate bond or a coordinate bonding. Along with these three types of bonding, few more type of bonds are exist, such that a metallic bond or a metallic bonding, hydrogen bond or a hydrogen bonding, likewise pi bond and sigma bonds. The following are the important types of chemical bonding, that is ionic bond, covalent bond, coordinate bond, metallic bond, hydrogen bond, pi bond and sigma bonds. The structure shows almost all type of the bondings. The first one, coming to the ionic bonding. Here, the transformation of electron from one atom to another atom is taking place. As we know already in the chemical bonding, a transformation of an electron from one atom to the another atom forming a stable compound is indicated by a ionic bond or simply a ionic bonding. Here, an electron from the valence shell of one atom is transforming to the valence shell of another atom so as to forming a stable compound. In this stable compound, the type of bonding is ionic bond. Likewise, the bond formed between two atoms by sharing up of an electron pair. Here, in between these two atoms, where both the atoms contributing one electron to the electron pair, that is sharing up of an electron pair between two atoms. Here, both the atoms are contributing one electron to the electron pair. So, such type of bonding is going to be called as a covalent bonding. Likewise, the third example indicates the metallic bonding. This example indicates the hydrogen bonding, and this indicates the coordinate bonding. So here all the structure indicates the different types of chemical bonding, that is ionic bonding, covalent bonding, coordinate bonding, metallic bonding, hydrogen bonding, as well as coordinate bonding. While explaining in detail about the chemical bonding, I am going to give details about the sigma bonds as well as pi bonds. So this gives a sigma bonding. Pi bonding. Here sigma bond is formed by the axial overlapping of two atomic orbitals, whereas pi bond is formed by the lateral or side by side overlapping of atomic orbitals. So sigma bond is a strong bond, whereas pi bond is a weak bond. Sigma bond is formed by the axial overlapping up of an atomic orbitals, indicating a stable bonding called as sigma bond, and this indicates the formation of a pi bonding where two atomic orbitals are overlapping side by side. Side by side overlapping forms a pi bond. Pi bond is a weak bond. Coming to the first type of bonding, that is ionic bond or ionic bonding or a electrovalent bond or simply a polar bond. Coming to the definition of ionic bond, ionic bond is a bond which is formed by the complete transformation of one or more electrons from the valence shell of electropositive atom to the valence shell of electronegative atom. Ionic bond is a bond which is formed by the complete transformation of one or more electrons from the valence shell of electropositive atom to the valence shell of electronegative atom in such a way that both the atoms in a molecule attains the nearest noble gas configuration. Coming to the explanation of an ionic bond. An ionic bond is formed by the complete transformation of one or more electrons from the valence shell of electropositive atom to the valence shell of electronegative atom in such a way that both the atoms acquire the nearest noble gas configuration. So during the formation of ionic bond, the atoms from which the electrons are transformed, that is, the atom which loses an electron acquire a net positive charge and becomes a cation, and the atom which gains the electron acquires a net negative charge and becomes a anion. The atom which loses an electron acquires a positive charge and becomes a cation, and the atom which gains an electron becomes a anion. If once a cation and anions are formed, there exists a electrostatic force of attraction. Due to the electrostatic force of attraction between the oppositely charged cation and anions, a bond is formed. Due to the electrostatic force of attraction between oppositely charged ions, a bond is formed, and this bond itself is going to be called as a ionic bond. In today's class, we have discussed about the introduction of chemical bond or a chemical bonding, various types of chemical bondings such as ionic bonding, covalent bonding, coordinate bonding, along with these three important types of bonding. There are four more types of bonds: metallic bond, hydrogen bond, sigma bond, and pi bond. Also, we have studied in detail about the definition or what is about the chemical bonding. So in my next class, I am going to give detailed explanation about the examples of ionic bonding by taking a sodium chloride.